The six-year-long alliance between the Congress and the National Conference came to an end today, with the Congress announcing its decision to go alone in the assembly elections in the state due in October-November. Within minutes, Omar Abdullah tweeted the decision to split had been the National Conference's, and that he had conveyed this to Sonia Gandhi more than 10 days ago. Mincing no words, he said the Congress was trying to distort facts. The alliance, which has been in power in Jammu and Kashmir since 2008, did not win even a single one of the state's six parliamentary constituencies in the general elections.
It's better not to depend on other party like we did in 2002 and 2008. We contested of our own. Let us contest of our own again.
We have decided to fight 87 seats. There may be some outstanding people who maybe wanted to stand as independents, and the party takes a considered opinion that they would be the best people for the state of Jammu and Kashmir. We might just support them also.
The Congress formally announcing the end of an alliance that has been uneasy at the best of times and deeply strained after the debacle in the parliamentary elections. But then the twist in the tale. Chief Minister Omar Abdullah making it clear that it was not the Congress, but his National Conference that took the decision to go alone in the state polls. Omar Abdullah tweeted, "I met Mrs. Gandhi 10 days ago and thanked her for all her support. I conveyed the NC's decision to fight the elections alone. I explained the reasons but also told her I would not be making a public announcement because I didn't want to look opportunistic. For it to be spun now as a Congress decision is wrong and a complete distortion of the facts. Not surprising, but incorrect nonetheless."
National Conference has already issued the list of candidates, and second list is going to be issued within 2 or 3 days. I think that is better for the both parties.
The two parties that came together only after the 2008 assembly elections threw up a fractured mandate in the state have had deep political and ideological differences. They have differed over the Armed Forces Special Powers Act, the settlement of refugees from Pakistan in Jammu, but perhaps most of all, over the hanging of Parliament attack convict Afzal Guru. Omar Abdullah then said it would have worrying long-term consequences for the valley. But if the ideological differences always existed, the debacle in parliamentary elections only widened the fissures further. Both parties accusing the other for the rout in which the Congress lost Jammu, Udhampur and Ladakh to the BJP, and the PDP made a clean sweep against the National Conference in the 3 seats in the valley.
So the marriage of convenience between the Congress and NC is coming to an end. While both parties say that the government will complete its full term, given the divergent political standpoints and their respective political compulsions, the government functioning in Jammu and Kashmir in next few months can be anything but smooth. In Srinagar, Nazir Masoodi for NDTV.
Well, joining us on our big debate tonight, the Jammu and Kashmir Congress President, Professor Saifuddin Soz. He's also Rajya Sabha MP for the Congress. From the National Conference, their spokesperson, Tanveer Sadiq. Nalin Kohli, spokesperson for the BJP and director of the party's Public Policy Research Centre, also joining me here in our Delhi studio. But Saifuddin Soz, let me come to you straight away. Soz, what really is the truth of the matter? Did the National Conference end this alliance, or did the Congress? And, you know, won't the manner of this split, with both parties claiming it was their idea, just isolate the Congress further?
It is. This analysis is absolutely wrong. Even our colleague who said these were the causes of Afzal Guru and AFSPA, etc., this is very misreading of the situation in Jammu and Kashmir. Let him come with me and go and meet people. What are the real causes of this? But I must say that when we decided to respond to the aspirations and demands from the Congress Party cadres, we listened to them patiently throughout the state in the 3 regions, and we responded and we said we shall go into the electoral process in 2014 all by ourselves. National Conference is entitled to what it wants to. It is not taking credit or discredit. If they had always wanted that, well and good. Even if they had not wanted, we took our decision. We are entitled to our decision. They are entitled to their decision and analysis. So there is no room for any controversy. We want to fight the election on our own. That is why we did previously also. It was just a break when we came for the coalition in 2008.
Okay,
so now we shall have it's a democratic process. They will try their luck, we shall try our luck, and we go.
A democratic process, you're saying, but what then were these?
This decision could not have generated any controversy. Now, if they say they had also said they also wanted, they are entitled to say that. Nobody will have any grounds.
But what were the causes of this split, sir? When you talk about the aspirations of the cadre, what is it that you're referring to exactly?
I must tell you one thing. You have given so many factors responsible. I reject that analysis altogether. Come on with me. I invite the whole panel. We go to Kashmir and talk to people, average people, ordinary people, and you will get to know things
so
better.
So are you saying, sir, but there are no ideological differences between you and the National Conference?
Ideological. Listen, there are differences. Our manifesto happened to be different. We didn't have a common minimum program because it was difficult. There are ideological differences, but that arena is different. This time, you must know that the major question was that of governance and the institutions of justice have become weak. And that is also a reason, and the levels of corruption, those are the reasons why Congress party workers felt almost frustrated. It is not my claim that Congress party ministers and leaders are not, you see, they are very clean, but the system has become so weak, the system has so become non-responsive, so the workers felt they would be better off to go to election democratically and
fair
use
point,
the secular
fair
space
point, let me
go
just,
to the people.
Let me just and bring in the National
this
Conference
is,
on that
this is
also.
Nothing. This is nothing rubbing wrong shoulders with the National Conference.
I would like to go across to the National Conference spokesperson also at this point. It's being talked about as a failure of governance. In a sense, the Congress seems to suggest that it was anti-incumbency against the National Conference government that really led to their own defeat in the polls in the seats that they contested. How does the National Conference respond to that? And also, why on a day when you're both pulling apart from this alliance, say that it was us, we decided first. What does this one-upmanship game, in a sense, yield for you?
Unfortunately, I'm really amazed with what Professor Soz is saying. You know, I think he forgets that 50% of the ministers were from his own party and all the major ministries are from it. So if anybody is pointing fingers towards one party, the four fingers are towards them as well. So it's not about, I don't believe that it's anything to do with the governance. It is more to do with what we have been saying all along, that 2010 was one of the reasons, the Modi wave in Jammu was a reason, the Afzal Guru hanging was a reason. There have been so many reasons for the debacle in the parliament election. But coming back to, I wish we had kept a dignified silence. The way Congress came out and started saying that, you know, we want to go alone. Of course, we could have done it in a dignified manner. Like Mr. Omar Abdullah had met Madam Gandhi 10 days back. And let me complete, Professor Soz. And then, you know, after meeting her, he had conveyed to her very clearly that you say now that perhaps you could have been silent, but within moments
of the Congress's press conference, we had Omar Abdullah saying for it to be spun now as a Congress decision is wrong, a complete distortion of facts, not
of course,
surprising,
gave,
not surprising.
That is the
what
reason they
mean?
Gave up, they gave out an impression that it was Congress pulling out. Unfortunately, they forget that it has been a successful coalition in the last 6 years. We have had some very good historical steps we have taken together. How can somebody take credit or discredit another one? But our point of view was that we also took feedback from the grassroots level, and we came out saying that, look here, this is not the way. We should go alone. We had conveyed it to the top leadership of the Congress, and that was the reason we took out the first list of our mandates around a week back. So we had already decided about going alone in this government, but we kept a dignified silence because we thought that this was a government that had run for 6 years.
All right, Professor Soz, yes, go ahead.
Listen to me, Madam Anchor. The question is that this position that has been taken up by National Conference doesn't do them any good. The point is that we announced that we shall go to the election 2014 all by ourselves. National Conference could say they also wanted the same thing. This one-upmanship is not correct politically because it creates an impression, and for that they are responsible, that as if National Conference had to swallow a bitter pill. The point is that they could say that they also wanted like the same thing. So, how? Because we announced our decision in response to the demand of the workers. We said, yes, we shall go to election 2014 all by ourselves. And National Conference could say, yes, they also wanted the same thing. Finished. But saying that we did something wrong and they must feel unhappy over
it. That was not in good taste.
No. It is not pulling. It is not the pulling the rug. You see, unfortunately, you had invited Mr. Sagar. Now he is not online. The point is that it is not pulling the rug. It is from under their feet. The point is that we just for our party, we are entitled to this, that we may go together in alliance or not. We have announced our decision after consulting workers in all the three regions.
Okay,
we go to election all by ourselves.
Both parties could have announced this amicably. You chose not to do it like that. Nalin Kohli, you say this doesn't come as a surprise.
Well, I think I find it, if you'll excuse me for the word, amusing. Normally, people fight to take credit for the creation of an alliance. This is one of those rare instances where I'm seeing people fighting to take credit for the breakup of the alliance. So, anyway, it's for them to decide whether they want to have an alliance or they do not want to have an alliance. Professor Soz, I've heard you and Tariq Saab. At least I'm delighted that my one sentence has brought the two of you together. But so be it. Let me just at least say my word. I've heard all your points. I have no interest whether you are in alliance or you are not. I really have no interest. That's between you all. I'm only making a comment to NDTV.
Yeah, if you don't have interest, you shouldn't comment on something you don't know.
Well, I mean, don't get your blood pressure up. It's not good for health. So anyway, coming back to the point I wanted to say is that basically the fact of the matter is, excuse me, Mr. Tariq, I can raise my voice and speak non-stop. You have no idea how capable I am of speaking non-stop.
All right, let's keep it there.
This is not a question of, taking it like this. You want to put it on national TV, go ahead.
Amicable or not, let's keep this debate amicable.
So anyway, let's come back to the point I want to make. It doesn't make a difference. The people of Jammu and Kashmir obviously have decided against this alliance. It's evident in the Lok Sabha elections. 6 out of 6 seats the Congress and the National Conference have lost. 3 the BJP has won. 3 have been won by the PDP. If you look at the vote percentage, the BJP has got the maximum vote percentage of almost 33%. The National Conference is a distant last at about 11%. So therefore, the writing is clearly on the wall. Its people want change, they want delivery. They don't want this kind of bickering and they don't want excuses. They want to ask clearly, is development given or not given? So as far as the BJP is concerned, we are preparing for Mission 44 and we are going ahead with it. And in the Congress has seen it that excuses didn't work at the national level.
To what extent is today's developments a fallout really of the kind of debacle we saw in the parliamentary elections? Is there now time for a complete rejig? The Congress today talked about a wider nationalist agenda and carrying that forward, which Ghulam Nabi Azad said could not be pushed through in view of compulsions of coalitions. What is this wider nationalist agenda that you've talked about?
You see, it is many issues were involved, but I will not take the position as President JKPCC that we couldn't push forward. We tried. We had a long battle with National Conference on 73 amendment, and they had their own idea about it. We found the state's Panchayat Act very deficient. There was a dispute, and we won that finally. 73rd amendment was adopted. But there are so many issues, like OBC question, other backward classes, they thought it was Jammu-centric. It is as much Jammu-centric as it is Kashmir-centric, as it is Ladakh and Kargil-centric, because who are OBCs? The oil man, the carpenter, the mason, the Shir Gujri, the Chopan. So we fought a battle for that. We want the reservation to go to 5%. It is possible. Then refugees. Jammu people this around this time adopted, I mean, Jammu Congress adopted a very good posture on the question of refugees. They left aside the West Pakistanis, in which government of India will also be closely involved. But the rest of the refugees who are state subjects from POK and some people among those refugees who were internally displaced in 65 and 71, they are bona fide citizens of Jammu and Kashmir state. So we wanted a package for them from government of India. So that has been lying before the cabinet. There are so many issues which are common to people of Ladakh and Kashmir and Jammu. That agenda could go forward. There were difficulties. But the major question is that we are totally secular. We have to fight BJP in Jammu, which is very communal. It polarized elections. It was not a simple election. And only Modi ji's name was put forward. It was not a victory for BJP. And you saw by the day, Mr. Modi is, you see, strengthening his grip over the party as well as on the government. BJP party itself will pay a high price for that.
It is not a good omen for the democratic process of the country. Let me get a response and from the BJP to this before I take this Kashmir. Back to the national conference.
Very kind of you, Professor Soz, to worry about the future of the BJP. Perhaps I think if you would apply the same concern on the Congress party, you might be able to help your own party. It's fascinating to know that you are worried about the future of the BJP when the Congress has almost become the size of a regional party.
Okay, I'm going to,
zero in 13 states,
you should
zero in seven
you
union territories,
on the
and, zero,
day,
and 1 minute in the glorious Minister, leadership of Mr. Rahul Gandhi. So I'm sure that you would like to go and give this advice to your party colleagues. Rather than worry about the BJP, which has made it to government.
Enormous money that went into paid news.
Professor Soz, why are you looking for excuses?
Professor Soz, you are a senior political person.
Okay, Tanya,
why are you looking for excuses for your failure?
You failed. People haven't accepted you.
Work on it. It's democracy. But don't worry about the BJP. Okay, we'll worry about our party ourselves.
I want to bring the national conference back.
You have a point. Finally, since we lost, we must accept that defeat. We do that.
All right.
We're a democratic country.
Okay.
Yeah, we win or lose.
That's very gracious, Saifuddin. So, Tanveer Sadiq, with assembly elections still 3 to 4 months away and your cadre now facing off in the polls, what are going to be the logistical problems, really, as far as running the government is concerned? Because you're still in an alliance there.
Well, this alliance was formed after election in 2008-2009. Both the Congress and NCE fought against each other, but then we formed a coalition for 6 years. The coalition will complete its term till November-December this year, and it has nothing to do with the future elections. Because what we decided today or what Congress has decided is about the next assembly election. But this government as of now is there. It's running. I don't see any danger to this coalition.
Okay, very quick last comments also. In 2008, this was not a pre-poll alliance. This was born out of really the fractured mandate there. Are you still and this question is to both parties, are you leaving the window open for a possible post-poll alliance, or is this not the time to discuss that? Professor Soz, if you'd like to go first.
Oh, yes. As per National Conference taking position that this government will run its course, at this point of time, I have no objection to that. My case is that we shall move forward. Maybe both parties will have to show patience where decisions will be taken in the cabinet. If both parties are reasonable, there is some sense in running the government for some time. So therefore, at this point of time, I will not quarrel with the National Conference on that question. But we shall see what will happen in future, what issues will be piloted, what will happen. That is for the...
Is the National Conference ruling out a post-poll alliance?
What happens after the election, we shall see.
Sir, let's not quarrel on anything. With regard to post-war alliance, let the bridge come and we'll think of crossing it.
All right.
Well,
I just have
a final comment. What we've seen so far in the Lok Sabha elections, if there are trends to go by, perhaps the two of them may want to get together to build a bridge. Because, you know, you may just not see a government there. We are working for Mission 44 ourselves.
Build a government there. Well, a partnership bittersweet at the best of times, now perhaps ending in active acrimony. What the future will bring? Well, that, of course, is the big question. And we'll have to wait for October, November and the results of the assembly elections in Jammu and Kashmir for that. Nalin Kohli, Professor Saifuddin Soz, Tanveer Sadiq, thank you for joining us on this discussion tonight.